He's 86 going on 87. 86.
Okay, when you said the secret is a younger wife, what's younger, like 20 years old?
30? 20 years is good.
20 is good?
Yeah. Okay, but tell the truth. How old is your wife now?
19 years old.
19.
She's a 19-year-old wife?
He's pulling your leg.
I asked my eyes. Hey, Andy, when you're 87, your wife will be 19?
Huh?
When you'll be 87, you'll have a 19-year-old wife?
Why not?
My wife now is 67 years old.
She's 67.
Okay. She's a spring chicken.
So he's
a spring chicken.
It's all relative. But he's a great dude and a very, very knowledgeable.
Well, let's talk about Remy for a minute. You know, compared to some of these other so-called strength and conditioning guys out there that think they know it all. Remy got his PhD in 1962, okay? So he's been training world-class athletes. So from 62 to 72, 80, 90, 2002, 2012. So well over 50 years of experience.
I want you to explain to me what they're doing right now. I've never seen shadow boxing. I mean, not shadow boxing, hitting the bag with weights.
No. You finish?
Finish.
Come here.
Why hit the bag with weights?
Extra resistance.
And it works.
But back to his level of expertise, yeah, and the things that he does. The bands that we use out on the track and we use them here, it's elastic strength. There's bands as well here. It's a different type of weight resistance because as you stretch the band, the resistance gets greater. If you put weights on and jump up, it's the same weight at the top of the jump as it is the bottom. On this machine, the farther you get, the higher you get, the more you stretch the band, the more resistance there is. So it's a different type of explosive speed and power that you develop using these bands as opposed to dead weight.
So hitting the bag with weights just increases the
resistance?
He has
them hit the wall, you know.
Darren, you're ready to take over.
You're not going to find this piece of equipment in a boxing gym.
Correct. It's most of the stuff here you won't find in boxing. Not the igloo, not the bike, not the oxygen.
Not the curve, you know. But we use something. We use both low oxygen, which, you know, that's the simulated high altitude training. Now, there are many places that have hypoxicators where they can do low oxygen. What you don't see is the oxygen concentrators and people using high oxygen. And you can use it several different ways, but initially, and one of the most important is to enhance recovery. So let me give you an example of how this works. And I told Mikey Garcia this, so I explained it to him, because he's into cars, as you know. So you're racing around the car or the track, you pull into the pit to add fuel. One guy comes out and he's got the container of gas, he's putting it in one snout and he fills it up and then he takes off, okay? Imagine if you had two snouts and two guys that came up and could put the same amount of gas in half the amount of time and they go out quicker, which means that if we enhance recovery and make that recovery time in half, you can go back and train. So the training load to recovery interval, it gets changed because we enhance the recovery side. Boxing thinks it's about grind, and grind some more. The recovery interval is equally as important as the training interval because that's when the actual tissue healing and repair and recovery happens, which is when the gains are made.
That's true.
So we're about the right balance and the right ratio between the training load and the recovery interval. And one way we enhance that is by using high oxygen.
And that's where they have Victor Conti right here at Snacks. Stay tuned for usagepoint.com. My sick back reporting.